The animals would not sleep. The animals were making a ruckus. It's getting close to bedtime, Marco's mom said. Time to put away your toys. You mean time to sort the animals, Marco said. That's what a scientist would do. Marco made signs for his baskets. He put each animal where it belongs. Flying animals, swimming animals, animals that move on land. But the animals would not go to sleep. They egged one another on until not one remained in its container. Perhaps they just weren't tired enough yet. Marco gave them a little more time to get their wild out. Marco, his mom called, almost ready? Almost, Marco called back. Marco studied his menagerie as a good scientist would. Maybe the animals would have better behavior if they were organized differently. He made new signs and tucked the animals in their appropriate baskets, mostly brown, black and white, colors of the rainbow. But Zebra was upset. While he didn't mind sleeping next to Stingray and King Snake, he missed his friend Giraffe. He started crying. Marco felt terrible. Your pouch is overtired now. That's why it seems like such a big deal, he told Zebra. He dumped all the animals out. Maybe he should group them by size. So medium-sized zebra and medium-sized giraffe could be together. It was hard to fit the large ones into their basket, but Marco squeezed them all in one. Small, medium, large. He started to put his pajamas on, but he didn't get far. A terrible sound was coming from the basket labeled large. Marco peered inside. I'm smushed, Dinosaur said. My spikes are bent. I'll never fall asleep. Me neither, said Dancing Flamingo. My neck is cramped. It did look uncomfortable. Plus, I miss Rainbow Bear, Dancing Flamingo added. What's going on in here? Marco's mother asked. Are you getting ready for bed? I'm trying, Marco said, but my animals aren't cooperating. Now, he heard squeezing and buzzing from the small animal bin. What's going on in there? Marco asked. Baby Mouse wants his mommy mouse, Spotted Dotty explained. Also, it's too cold for us in this big drafty basket, Turtle added. 2 more minutes, Marco's mother called. Marco had to think fast. Being a scientist, he was used to coming up with ideas and thinking outside the box. He dumped the animals back onto the floor. Can't I just sleep in your bed tonight? Whined Birthday Bear. Yellow Bear started crying for no reason at all. Everyone was getting cranky and time was running out. Marco knew that good scientists care about their animals. Helping them feel safe and cozy was important. He also knew that sorting could still work. He placed the large animals at the foot of his bed where there was plenty of room to stretch out. He placed the medium animals along the wall. And he placed the small animals behind his pillows where they would feel snug and warm. He leaped into bed just in time.